My name is Billy Terry, and I'm the product manager for sensor sampling. Today I'll be doing a live demonstration of the LGSS, the liquefied gas sample system, and showing you some of the operation and actually allowing you to see how the outage is collected, as well as how you can get a visual indication of the flow through this system. So the LGSS system is designed to be installed in a fast loop off the main line, not directly in the main process line. The sample inlet and outlet are back here on the back, and sample is actually circulating through the system, up through the cylinder, down through the sight glass, and back to the process. So as the cylinder is installed in the LGSS system, it's very important for the operator to know that he or she actually has flow through the system. We have a pressure indicator on the system that actually indicates the pressure inside the system, but in order to get a good indication of if there is flow through, it's very important that you utilize a sight glass that has an impeller inside that's actually spinning and see, so you can actually see that you have good flow through the system prior to collecting the sample. So after indicating proper flow, what we're actually able to see is that the cylinder has been filled all the way up and is actually flowing back down around while we're in that sample position. So prior to removing the cylinder, our goal here is to get an outage in the cylinder. That outage protects the cylinder from overpressuring during transportation back to the lab, if it gets in the sunlight or if it gets jostled around. So we need to get that outage prior to removing the cylinder. So what we'll actually do is we'll turn this to bypass, and what we'll try to do in this step is indicate to you what exactly is happening in this cylinder to obtain that outage. So as you can see here, the sight glass is full of sample, which means that the sample cylinder is also full. And in order to remove that cylinder, we need to get a proper outage, typically about 20% outage in the top of that cylinder. So visually looking at the volume in the sight glass, we're wanting to be at a 50% level here, which indicates our 20% outage in the cylinder. And this is typical for the LGSS design. So now that we have a liquid full cylinder and we need to obtain the outage, opening the sample vent valve actually drops the pressure in the loop, and by dropping that pressure we get to that point where it begins to vaporize. The vapor will start to slowly collect to the top and the liquid will settle to the bottom. Eventually what we'll see here is an actual outage and a level in this sight glass, which indicates the same level in the cylinder. So with the sample loop completely full of liquid at this point, by opening the sample vent valve, which is connected to typically a flare line, we're able to begin to drop the pressure in that loop. As we drop that pressure, that line is beginning to vaporize and turn into a gas as that pressure drops. And that vaporization is happening at the bottom and the top, but all the vapor begins to collect at the top and the liquid remains at the bottom due to gravity. Once that level is actually dropped to the 50% level in the sight glass, that is indicating that we also have the proper 20% outage in our cylinder and we can shut the valve. So now that we've got our proper outage in the cylinder, we'll want to go ahead and lock in that cylinder and shut those cylinder valves. Now it is time to remove all the remaining pressure from the quick connect prior to removing the cylinder. So again, we'll open our sample vent valve, allow the system to completely depressurize so the quick connects have no pressure remaining. And then once that has happened, we'll close our sample vent valve and we can now remove our sample cylinder to go back to the laboratory. Thank you for watching our video today on the live demonstration of the LGSS. For more information, visit our SOR YouTube channel.